sila na patuloy nilang gawin yung tama. Pero kapag kamali, discipline. Pagsabihan, hindi nakuha sa sabi, paluin, hindi nakuha sa palo, pagpapaluin. Ganun yun. At makukuha yan. Pastor, paano mo natiyak? Eh, ito yung turo ng Diyos eh. Maaring hindi ko maintindihan, maaring hindi ko alam, but I know God knows what He is doing. And this is what He wrote in the Bible, so therefore we need to obey it. Look at Galatians 6, 7 to 9. Ito, alam natin lahat ito. Napakaliwanag. Be not deceived, God is not mocked. For whatsoever a man soweth, that shall he also reap. They must understand, sowing and reaping, even when they are still young. That if you sow, for he that soweth to his flesh, shall of the flesh reap corruption. But he that soweth to the Spirit, shall of the Spirit reap life everlasting. And let us not be weary in well-doing, for in due season we shall reap, if we faint not. If they will sow in the flesh, disobedience, there will be consequence. But if they will obey, there will be reaping. And then as a parent, we are encouraged not to let be weary in well-doing, because time will come, we are going to become proud of our children if we will discipline them while they're young. Number four, bilisan na po natin. Reassure and teach after the discipline is over. Reassure and teach after the discipline is over. Do not just spank them. This is how you do it. This is how I do it with my children most of the time. Because as a human being, there are times that I spank them out of emotion, which is very wrong. Because it will instill rebellion in their heart. But this is how you do it. You tell them, this is the rule, or these are the rules. If you disobey, I'm going to spank you. So, when they disobey, tell them, come here. What is our rule? Like this, I do not have to go there. Did you go there? Yes. So, you disobey the rule? Yes. So, what will be the consequence? Spanking. So, you know that I'm going to spank you, right? Yes, I know, because I did what is wrong. So, the reason why you're spanking him is because you do not want him to continue doing what is wrong. After you spank the child, listen. And after you explain why, and after you spank the child, you pray, and after praying, reassure the child that you love him. That when you are spanking him, you are the one who is actually getting hurt because they are your children. Inasmuch as you do not want to do it, it is necessary so that they will not grow up to be a rebellious person. And this is the same thing as God is doing to us as His children. Look at Hebrews chapter 11, verse number 11. This is very clear. 12:11. Hindi pompyang, pakatayaan. Now, no chastening, for the present seemeth to be joyous, but grievous. Nevertheless, afterward, it yieldeth the peaceable fruit of righteousness unto them which are exercised thereby. Walang paluan na masaya. Pero masakit. Pero kanya, pagkatapos naman nun, magbubunga ng kapayapaan at katuwiran sa bawat isa na nakakadanas nito. Look at verse number 5, 6 and 7 of the same chapter. And ye have forgotten the exhortation which speaketh unto you as unto children. Sabi ng Panginoon, my son, despise not thou the chastening of the Lord. So when we commit sin, the Lord will chastise us. Nor faint when thou art rebuked of him. For whom the Lord loveth, he chasteneth and scourgeth every son whom he receiveth. Ano raw? Yung mahal daw ng Diyos, pinapalo niya. Look at verse number 7. If ye endure chastening, God dealeth with you as with sons. For what son is he whom the father chasteneth not? Meron bang anak kanya na hindi pinapalo? Ang Diyos ang nagsabi nito. Oh, pero pag wala kang palo, ito matindi. Tinan mo. 8. But if ye be without chastisement, whereof all are partakers, then you are bastards and not son. Bastardo ka, hindi ka anak. See? So if you love your children, you spank them. Why? Because they will commit something wrong. So that you will teach them how to navigate their way out of that sinful habits that they are doing. Number five, almost finished. Avoid impossible demands to your children. Avoid impossible demands to your children. Ephesians 4:6. Tinan mo ito, ha? Makinig kayo. Ha? Ito naman tayo. Ephesians 6:4. I'm sorry. 6:4. And ye fathers and mothers also, provoke not your children to wrath, but bring them up in the nurture and admonition of the Lord. So do not give them impossible demand. What is that? When you are provoking them to anger. How is that? You will tell them, don't do this, but you are doing it. That is an impossible command. Yung tito ko, hindi ko sinunod yung kahit minsan eh. Sabi niya sa akin, huwag kang maninikarilyo habang umuusok yung bibig niya at ilong niya. Tapos, anyway, na patay na siya. Hindi ko alam kung nasa lang. Ito, nasa impyerno. Hindi na kami nakita ng matagal na panahon. Meron kami mga baboy. May babuyan kami. Sabi niya, nawawalan kami ng baboy araw-araw. Pinagulitan ako, ikaw talagang inutil ka kanya. Wala kang magawa sa buhay. Kung saan saan ka nagpupunta. Maglagi ka nga rito, magbantay ka. At ninanakawan tayo ng baboy kanya araw-araw. Ginawa ko, nung gabi, nagtago ako rin sa isang kulungan. Tiniis ko yung amoy ng baboy. Pamaya-maya, merong yabag na ano, papalapit dun sa mga kulungan ng baboy. Tapos may maliit na pen light. And then, may dalang sako. Isinisilid na yung isang malaki-laking biik. Tayo kong gano'n, prelastment ko. Tipo ko. Hindi mo naman pala ka ako eh. Pagkagalitan mo ako, sasabihin mo ako inutil na huwag akong na magbantay ako eh. Minanaka ako, ikaw palamag na lang ako, wake up. You teach your children to respect their mother, you hurt their mother. You shout at their mother. You do not respect their mother. You treated them as if they are not an important person in your life, and then you tell your children, respect your mother, respect your father, and you make their father a henpeck under desire. Sinisigawan mo. That is an impossible command. How can they do that? How can they obey you when you are the ones disobeying your own command? You are showing a bad example to your children that there is no way for them to obey you, because if they will obey you, they will grow up contrary to what you are teaching them. They are in a lose-lose situation. Let us look at Colossians 3:21. Fathers, provoke not your children to anger, lest they be discouraged. Do not discourage them. You see, sometimes we do not understand that we're discouraging our children when we do this. Example, we tell them, this is the rule. When you break this, I'm going to spank you. And they broke the rule and you did not spank them. In their mind, they will say, my father and my mother is a liar. Because they told me that if I will do this, they will spank me. And they did not. So I cannot believe what they are telling me anymore. Ang hirap eh. Kunin mo yan. Iligpit mo. Sabi sa anak mo, hindi iniligpit. Kunin mo, iligpit mo. Hindi iniligpit, umalis. Iligpit ko na nga. Patay. Paano matututo anak natin? Pag sabing kunin mo, iligpit mo, magunaw na ang mundo. Kukunin mo yan. Ililigpit mo yan. Kayo mga kapatid, sa biyaya ng Panginoon, before I end, itong last natin, ano na lang, very simple na lang. Before I end, the reason why I'm teaching this is by the grace of God, we were able to train our children. They're not perfect. You know that. But all of them grew up loving the Lord. Why? Because it was instilled in their hearts, inculcated in their mind while they were young. Yung mga anak ko, kasing edad dito mga yan, hindi mo maririnig mag-iingay sa loob ng church. Kahit kasama namin, parang wala kaming kasamang bata. Pag nag-start na ang preaching, makikinig na. Parang mga bata natin ngayon. Hindi magtatakbo yan, hindi maglalaro. May mga churches akong pinupuntahan. Habang nagpipreach yung tatay, pupunta yung anak, kakalabit-kalabitin ng tatay, tatay, penging pera. Mga kapatid, tandaan nyo! Balik mo yung sukli. Tandaan nyo! Ano yung tatandaan natin? Nakalimutan na kasi kung ano yung in-entertain eh. Tapos nagtatakbuhan, nagsisigawan ng mga bata. If you allow them to do that, they will grow up disrespecting the church of God. And you cannot let them stay while in the church. Kaya nakakalungkot. Kaya nga here, we train our children. By the grace of God, at the start, ang hirap, di ba? Ingay. Iiyak. Tatakbo. Yung magulang talagang hindi alam ang gagawin. Pero slowly but surely, they're learning. Now, they can sit beside you. They can listen to the preaching. And if not, then you tell them. Huwag kang magsawa, kapatid. Ang pagdidisiplina matagal. Mahirap, paulit-ulit. Pero huwag kang magsawa. Dahil pag lumaking disiplinado yan, sasabihin mo, praise God. Salamat sa Panginoong Diyos. Meron akong mga anak na may takot sa Diyos. At hindi ko nagagarantiya sa inyo, hindi ka mapapaya, hindi ka lulungkot, hindi ka luluha. They're still in the flesh. They can still commit sin. Their peers can still make them drift away from the truth of the Word of God. But because there is already a planted Word of God, if worse comes to worse, there is always a way of escape for them to go back to. And that is the Word of God. And lastly, when you discipline, let love be your guide. You discipline them because you love them, not because you hate them, but because you love them. Look at Song of Solomon chapter 6, verses 14 to 19. Ito maganda to eh. Song of Solomon chapter 6. 14 to 19. Wala ba nun? Walang 14? Ano itong sinulat ko? Sigurado kayo? Anak kita, niloloko mo ako. Yan ba ang training mo? Song of Solomon. Ano yung isa? Four to nine kaya? Four to nine siguro. Oh, thou art beautiful. Okay na to. Thou art beautiful, O my love. As Tirsa, comely as Jerusalem, terrible as an army with banners. Tuloy mo. Turn away thine eyes from me, for they have overcome me. Thy hair is as a flock of goats that appear from Gilead. Tuloy mo. Maganda to. Thy teeth are as a flock of sheep which go up from the washing whereof everyone beareth twins. Pag may twins kayo, ha? Ito yung ano nyo. And there is not one barren among them. Proverbs 23, 13 to 14. Ayan pala ang ibig ko sabihin. Proverbs 23, 13 to 14. Withhold not correction from the child. For if thou beatest him with a rod, he shall not die. Wala akong mamamatay sa palo sa puwet, ha? Huwag sa ulo. Kaya ano sabi ko nung nakaraan lesson natin? Ang puwet ay dinisign ng Diyos na makapal. Kaya dito paluan. Pero kung anak mo, makapal ang mukha. Dito ang paluan. Ayan, ha? Maliwanag yan. Ang kapal ng mukha mo! Ganon. Pero dito dapat. Kasi dito, kahit lakasan mo, walang structural damage. Wala talagang dinesign ng Diyos yan para dyan disiplinahin ang bata. So huwag mong papaluin kung saan-saan. Ang palo laging sa puwet. At ang gamit mo, rod, o yung maayos na paddle, hindi kahit na ano mahawakan mo. Nahawakan mo, itak, pinalo mo. Hati, yung anak mo. Hindi ganon. He shall not die. Thou shalt beat him with the rod. What will be the result? Tingnan niyo ito. And shalt deliver his soul from hell. Kita mo? When you discipline your child, he will grow up respecting authority, respecting God, receiving Jesus, repenting of his sin, and becoming a child of God. But if you will not discipline them, they will reject authority, reject God, and they will die, and they will go to hell. Child discipline is one way of evangelism or evangelizing our children so that they will grow up respecting God. So I hope and I pray that this lesson will be applied by all of our parents. Children, listen, this lesson is not because we want to scare you, no. We love you and we want you to understand that if ever those things will happen, your parents does not hate you. They love you so much that they are willing also to be hurt so that you will grow up as children respecting God in your lives. That's why we allow you to sit here even when we have service so that when somebody is standing behind the pulpit and preaching the Word of God, you listen. You may not understand everything that we are saying, but believe me, what you are hearing is being stored back of your mind. And God will use that when you grow up in order for you to remember the lessons that you have heard from the Word of God. So I hope and I pray that we will not only learn how to discipline our children, but most importantly, we will learn how to show them how to be obedient in the things that we are telling them to be obedient. Shall we stand up, please?